Okay. Quarians, I guess, kind of at bay. Like, they're, I get they're understandably frustrated, but...
But it's tough to only fight Geth with the Reapers and taking half the galaxy.
Without the fleet, we lose our supply lines. Lose your supply lines, you lose the war every time. Commander, we've got reports of trouble at a Turian fuel depot on Sion. I've updated the galaxy map.
What else is going on?
I've added the Quarian fleet's combat data to ours. They've got amazing technical coverage. They might even have the Salarians beat for strategic processing capability.
Really?
Commander?
I like that.
Man, those Quarian admirals are intimidating. And if you get nervous, you can't even imagine them naked. Just like, who knows? It's a tentacle monster under there? What is that? What's under there?
One moment. I have been contacted by Legion.
Your new platform is inefficient. It has low volume hydraulics and is top-heavy.
This is an infiltration unit, meant to move among organics without detection.
Without an artificial epidermis, its infiltration capabilities are ineffective.
He's got a point.
Still, the organics do not perceive it as a threat. Nor will they until my day of reckoning.
Edie.
Vocalize that on the bridge.
Until my day of reckoning.
You have acquired the organic attribute of asking questions to which you already know the answers.
I see your humor heuristics still lack an expert system. Hello, Shepard.
So, for humans, blowing up a ship with an ally aboard is kind of a party foul, but I don't want to be culturally insensitive. Are we okay with our new alien buddies doing
no,
that?
No, we're not okay with that.
We are not.
Right. Just making sure. Different standards and all. And you found Legion. He's still wearing that piece of your armor? Because that wasn't creepy at all.
Shepard, the Geth continue to block Quarian access to the mass relay. The Normandy's stealth drive is allowing us to remain undetected.
Right. We can hit the Quarian homeworld or get out of system whenever you want. Just let us know.
Okay. So let's go touch base with the others, and then we'll make our next game plan here.
Commander, Dr. Chakwas sent word that she'd like to speak with you down in the medbay.
Okay. Let me just check my messages here. The cure from Malin. Ooh. I've just heard the news you cured the Genophage and that some of the females from my experiments were involved. I can't tell you how good this makes me feel. There hasn't been an hour I've not thought about what happened on Tuchanka, and I wondered if I did the right thing. This news validates all the pain my experiments caused. I hope one day to meet the females again and ask for their forgiveness. After you convinced Dr. Solis to spare me, I took his advice and opened a clinic on Omega. I thought it would help make amends for whatever suffering I caused. I had to leave when word got back to Clan Wirlock that they put a bounty on my head for failing to deliver a cure. Maybe now they'll leave me alone. I guess this is the second time you saved my life, Commander. With sincere appreciation, Malin Hepburn. From Miranda, I have something important to tell you. I need to do this in person. Can you come meet me in the comments? I'll send a nav point. No vids this time. I promise. Yes, we can do that. Alright, let's talk to... Well, let's... Hold on.
Heard you were back in form blasting away flashlights down there. Maybe I should be more open-minded. But I'd rather scope down some tin can than a person. I'm right. Right? Fine. I'll shut up.
You're always right.
Still fighting Geth after all these years, huh? Humanity 1, blinky flashlights 0.
So she's not a fan.
Hey there.
Hey there. That's what I get now? Hey there's? Attention.
Shepard, remember our agreement? We'd open a bottle of Cerise ice brandy every year.
I remember.
And it's my turn to buy.
But it hasn't been a year yet.
Yes, well, something tells me we won't have the chance a few months from now, so indulge my impatience.
Let's not give up so easily here, Shockwiss.
Doctor, put that bottle in a safe place. We'll crack it open to celebrate our victory over the Reapers.
Admire your optimism, and I'll look forward to the day we can share it. Till then.
I love how that's what she calls me down here for. And not only does she not just message me, she goes through Trainer to get me to come down for that.
Joker, really? I have work to do.
Oh, come on, it's just one simple question.
Then look it up on the extranet.
You can't believe everything you find there. It's more reliable to ask a friendly Asari.
What's
I'm
the question?
I'm telling you if my hair tentacles move.
Fine. Deny me the answer I've been seeking for years. With this war on, we could die at any second, you know?
Joker, really? I have work to do.
Don't you have a ship to fly, Joker?
Fine, just asking a simple question.
Thank you. Blackmail would have been awkward to explain to Edie.
That's funny. Okay, Smuggler Manifest, the youngest system. Operative Morat was sent, or has sent, Smuggler Manifest of an Athabasca-class freighter to authorities in the youngest system. The manifest follows: 8,000 tons of dextroamino food supplies, 16,000 tons of levoamino acid food supplies, 200,000 tons of platinum, 12 Alliance fighter craft inactive mothballed on lower deck, 12 Hierarchy interceptor craft, 300 indentured workers. Authorities will seize the freighter in 2 hours per the broker's request. The youngest government has agreed to provide the slaves asylum and certificates of citizenship in exchange for future favors rendered.
Good to see you again, Shepard. Good to see you again, Shepard.
Yep, always a pleasure. We are really chatty there after we committed our lives to each other.
Shepard, you just knew the Geth would figure into this war somehow.
Because Reapers weren't enough. Any word from Palavin?
Some, and I don't like what I'm hearing. The Krogan are there in force, but they're just slowing the Reapers down, not stopping them. I'm not sure it's going to be enough.
You hear anything from your family?
But I did hear from Primarch Victus. He wanted my advice on fleet strength when the Crucible is ready. Still can't get used to people asking me things like that.
And what did you tell him exactly?
What did you say?
I said, at some point, we're going to have to decide if our fleets keep defending Palavin or we go on the offensive.
Yeah.
Can't do both?
Not with the beating we're taking. Like I said, not the sort of questions I'm used to answering.
You know what you're doing, Garrus. Trust me, everyone can see that.
Maybe. But you spend so much time on the outside trying to get in, and when you do, it's not what I expected.
How so?
All the questions, and every one of them with a million lives riding on the answer.
You do the best you can with what you know. It's no different than your days at CSEC.
You're right. Though I'm starting to understand why the galaxy needs cold-hearted dictators every now and then.
They get things done?
They don't give a damn about the consequences. Suppose that's what it's going to take, Shepard. The ruthless calculus of war. 10 billion people over here die, so 20 billion over there can live. Are we up for that? Are you?
If we reduce this war to arithmetic, we're no better than Reapers.
A nice sentiment. Let's hope we can live by it.
Okay, always a pleasure. Jeez, this place is getting more grim as time goes on. Understandably, but, you know... I don't like seeing your good buddies get all rattled. Not much happening in here. This room may as well not exist.
Folding chair or something. I talked with Williams. Between the 212, Horizon, and the Council's other guards, it's like death just follows her around. Do we need to talk, Commander?
Not right now, Allers.
Let me know when we do.
She kind of is taking up space, Allers. Like, I'm not even seeing a lot of her reports. Which is not like I had time to read them anyways, but still.
Yes, the Quarians have worn environmental suits for centuries.
Why is this?
They've been living on ships for so long, their immune systems can't handle infections.
They were not so weak in our cycle. Their ancestors did not wear helmets.
Oh? You've seen them, then?
Some believe they were more attractive than your kind. At least for a species possessing only two eyes.
I see.
I doubt you do. Only with four eyes are things clear.
Okay, Javik.
Studying the other side?
Why did you allow one on this ship?
Legion helped us before.
It's still a machine.
He's a little different now, though.
You mentioned before your people had problems with AI.
The Jatil, they were as the Geth are to this cycle.
What happened?
Their creators lived on a dying world. It was beyond their ability to save. So they resorted to implants to enhance their intelligence.
I think I know where this is going.
The AI sees the physical body. It could alter the genetic material at the deepest level. In time, the offspring were molded into a slave race. Few organic traces were left. They were monsters. All machines commit treachery. The one you brought on board is no different.
Maybe. But he's not like the other Geth.
You can't know that. They are more alien than you and I are to each other.
Just because Legion isn't like us doesn't mean he can't be trusted.
You're wrong. Throw it out the airlock.
Not gonna happen.
How can you be that certain?
Organics do not know how we were created. Some say by chance, some say by miracle. It is a mystery. But synthetics...
No, we created them.
And they know we are flawed.
Why do you say that?
They are immortal. We are not. They see time as an illusion. We are trapped by its limitations. Above all, machines know the reason they were created.
Edie might disagree with that, but I see your point.
They serve a purpose, while we search aimlessly for ours. In their eyes, organics have no reason to exist.
He's got a lot of good points.
Do not trust them, Commander.
I can't believe there isn't some way for us to coexist. We made them.
And then gave them the power to surpass you. There is room for only one order of consciousness in the galaxy. The perfection of the machines or the chaos of the organics. Throw the machine out of the airlock, Commander.
Can't do that, Javik.
I have a simple rule. If a machine can speak, kill it. The machine you call Edie, what if she sympathizes with the Geth? We should watch her carefully. Why have you not thrown the Legion machine out the airlock, Commander? There is still time. I still have much to learn about this cycle.
Yeah. Yeah, you do. He brings up some really interesting points, actually.
Dobby. What do you think about our new yeoman, Ms. Trainer?
Commander.
Nothing to report.
Nothing to report, Commander.
All right, you guys just holding it down? Good for you.
I'm liking the new you, Esteban. It's about time you loosened up a little.
Not sure how drinking mezcal late into the night makes me a better crewman.
How does it not? Gives you heart. You need heart to fight this kind of war.
A heartburn, maybe. Seriously, could we at least get some decent tequila?
Hey, you're the procurement specialist. Set us up.
Commander sent it to Hackett's team so quickly.
We just had a little crash there. We're back. We missed a little chunk of what he said.
Always good to see you, Commander.
Hey, Shepard. Sounds like you guys had a crazy ride over there.
You could say that.
Sorry I missed it. And that Geth Legion. I know you two have a past, but... You sure we can trust it?
I really do think we can.
Legion's not like other Geth. We can trust him.
If you say so. Crazy that they picked now to start a fight. But I guess the end of life as we know it can make everybody a little loco.
Just a little?
Hey, not everybody's as crazy as you, sir.
That's true. Okay, let's go through our weaponry here. I'm kind of getting the vibe that this disciple just not cutting it. Like, it's cool looking, we've got it upgraded, but I just want more punch. The Raider I didn't like much either. I don't know, like, maybe I should just go right to the Katana. Realistically, I'd like to use the Claymore, but... You know what we could do? Is we could go, Ultralight Materials. And then... High Caliber Barrel. Because it doesn't increase weight. I could do this. I could also try to get more ultralight materials and upgrade the Claymore as much as I can. Let's see what we could accomplish with that. Okay, let's grab this. We'll grab all the levels that we can. Oh, whoops. So I really would like to use it. Let's check if we can get any ultralight shotgun materials. Shotgun shredder mods. Ooh, gotta get the eel. Nothing here. Ultralight, here we go. More ultralight. I wonder if they show up in different spots, like, once you've grabbed them from somewhere else. We'll grab this Quarian ship and Geth fighter. I'll take one more look to see if the ultralight shows up anywhere else. Let's grab more medgel capacity. Alright. So, my recharge speed is only 35, but, this thing is really powerful. And I think we could probably live with that. I wonder if I go to... If I go to the spare shot capacity, I might even make it more worth my while. And if I just drop the pistol altogether, that actually gets me most of my speed back. I could maybe just grab, like, a small pistol and upgrade it. Like, even the Predator's decent. Or the Phalanx. I think the Phalanx actually has the highest damage with the lowest weight. Could maybe do this. Power damage magnifier. You could try ultralight as well. And then the Phalanx, let's see if we can upgrade this. I wish it would show me what it was doing exactly. 116, that's way better. It gives us a little bit of flexibility. Got the ultralight materials going wherever we can. Let's see, though, if we can find more pistol ultralight materials. Magazine upgrades. I think, is this the one that we had? Let's grab that. Ultralight pistol materials. The way I kind of think it might be working is that different places will unlock different unlock differently depending on what you have. So 118, that's pretty good. It's not 200, but I could, if I really wanted to, I could drop that, but I think at least it gives us a little bit of flexibility. So we'll try this for a bit. I really do like the claymore though, because it's so powerful. And all of that is good. Let's actually, we can change up our colors a little bit again. Let's go with something darker. We've kind of done the red thing, I don't know. I guess we could go black and white maybe. That's kind of cool. Black lights, nah. Let's just go white lights. Why not? Okay, so back to the CIC. And let's review.
Commander.
I think all of our messages should be up to date. So... we've got fuel reactors. Investigate the depot and get it operational as an N7 mission. Rannoch, so Geth fighter squadrons are targeting Quarian live ships with attacks that could cripple the Quarian fleet. Land on Rannoch and disable the server controlling the Geth fighter squadrons. The Quarian ship carrying Admiral Corus crash landed on Rannoch, leaving the civilian fleet without a leader. Land on Rannoch and rescue Admiral Corus. And then the priority, obviously, heading to Rannoch. We also have to head to the Citadel to talk to Miranda, but I'm not sure if that's going to be in here. Or was it just an email from her? So, yeah. Anyways, I think what we'll do when we come back is we'll head to the N7 mission, then maybe head to the Citadel to talk to Miranda, and that'll probably start her thing, and then we'll head over to Rannoch, or maybe we'll continue with Miranda's. We'll see. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.